Hello and welcome to Thomson Reuters video tutorial. In this video, we are going to show you how to retrieve data from Thomson Reuters tick history in R language. Tick history is a host delivery platform for historical cross-asset financial data. The data can be extracted using REST API, which is connected to our data scope server. A data scope user account is required because the API uses to authenticate to the server. If you don't have the user account yet, please contact our sales representative. Before we start, you are encouraged to visit the data scope API help page. The help page is a primary source of reference for our all RESTful function and support condition. It also has API reference for HTTP request example. Let's get started with the user authentication. Obtaining user authentication involves making an HTTP POST request to the data scope server. If the request succeeds, you will receive an authentication token that can be used for further requests. To match HTTP POST request, we will use HTTR package. The HTTR package is a wrapper for CURL package that provides function for merge HTTP verb. To install the package, just use install package command. Once you install the package, you can load it with library command. In order to obtain user authentication, we need to know the request format. You can check the HTTP request example from API reference tree. The example shows you the URI and the body of the post. We will use HTTP example here to make a POST request in R language. From the example, we have URI, and the body. To make a POST request, we use HTTR POST, we supply the URI body and we add the header, which is add header prefer response async. And content type. JSON. And then store a request in the variable. With a response object from a request, we want to extract only the authentication token from the response. We use HTTR content to extract the content from the response. Then we can check the format of the response from the API reference tree. Here we can see the response is in JSON format. So use parse application JSON Okay, let's try running the code. Here you can see that we already got response from the server, but because we didn't supply the correct username or password, we got the invalid username or password response from the server. So what if we use the correct username and password? Right. okay. Here we got a token. Now that we have authentication token, we shall try requesting your user information. Each HTTP request after the first user authentication must include the authentication token on the header. Authentication tokens are valid for 24 hours, after which a 401 authentication required status code will be returned. First, let's check the example HTTP request form. You can see that requesting user information use HTTP GET and it requires authorization token. However, the format of authorization token is token, then space, and then followed by your token. Okay, so let's copy the code. So here we already have token. Let's put it in a variable. But the token is just your authorization token. We have to create a full string of authorization tokens. So we use paste and we paste the word token together with the result from the login. Don't forget that the result will be in a list and the token is under the node name value. We specify separation as space. Okay, now we got a token. To request user information, we use the URI. This can be it is URI 2. With the URI, we made HTTR get with URI to and we add authorization token. Let's put it in R2 variable. After that, we get a content from the response tool. Okay, let's try running this. A2. Here, you get user information from the server. With a working token. Next, we are going to retrieve a venue by day file via standard exception. Venue by day files are historical market data automatically generate daily after market close. It contains all of an exchange trading data for the day. These files are permissioned by package, where each package represents a single venue. So first, let's check the example on API help page. The first step is getting the list of all packages available to you. You can request package list by sending GET to user package URI. With this list request, the URI will return a list of packages available to your account. Each package has package ID and package name. Let's say we want the historical data of Nordic growth market. We must retrieve the list of data file available from this package. So let's look at the second step of the example. The second step is get user package delivery, which is the data file. By package ID. The ID here is user package ID. Since we want historical data of Nordic, we use the package ID of the Nordic market. Copy the user packet ID. And replace the one in the example. As you can see, the request will return a list of user packet delivery under this packet ID. Each user packet delivery will have the subscription ID the name of the file, the release date, time of the file size in byte, and the content MD5, which you can use for content MD5 checksum. However, retrieving the list of packet delivery will return only the most recent 250 rows. This is because Thick History REST API use server-driven paging to ensure that the quantity of data does not overwhelm the application. The return list will contain a next link that points to the next partial set of items. You have to use the next link to get the next set. The final set will not have the next link. In the final step, we will retrieve the file and save them to a local disk. This is done one file at a time. Standard extraction feeds always deliver file in a pre-compressed format. This is because when you buy their content size can be huge. It would increase the burden on the server and bandwidth were the file not compressed. The large file size also means that we cannot cache the response locally in the memory. The file should be saved directly to the disk. The ID here is user packet delivery IDs. For the sake of demonstration, we are going to use the smaller file. This file is on weak end, so it may not have a lot of data in it. Now, in order to save the file to the disk, we use write disk. We can specify the file path and file name. We can also specify whether we want it to overwrite an existing file. Another thing that we have to do is we have to disable the default HTTP content decoding. We can do this by add config HTTP underscore content underscore decoding and set it to 0. And finally, we can also add progress so that we can see the progress of the download. Now let's run it. As you can see, it's done. After this, you can use read.csv. Read.csv can read the compressed file, so there's no need to decompress it first. Now, how can you move forward? The developer portal holds many resources, and these are located under Thomson Reuters Thick History API section. If you are still not familiar with the API, we recommend you begin by going through the quick start first. This gives you the example application that illustrates most of the API calls. It shows HTTP requests and respond just like the API reference tree. The document section includes some very useful guides, which include T TK3 recipe and user guide, and also TK3 data dictionary and data coverage guide. If you have question or issue, you can go into the portal forum. Select the proper area for TK3. Here you can search a pair of query, or you can post a new one. This forum is monitored by developers in all regions of the globe. Thank you for following this tutorial. We hope you found this instructive.